Are you being as productive as you can be in Gmail? Feel like your inbox is out of control? Well, this video is all about Gmail productivity. So get ready to spend less time in Gmail. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a ton of Google tips. Like seriously, it's a ridiculous amount. Today, we're diving back into Gmail, and this time we're going to help you get control of your inbox. And no offense to Gmail.
Love you, boo.
But our time is valuable, so isn't it time we spent less time in Gmail? Yeah, my thoughts exactly. Gmail tip number one, snooze email messages in order to take care of them later. It's amazing how many people don't take advantage of this built-in feature. And if you get easily distracted like I do, squirrel, you'll definitely want to take advantage of this built-in Gmail snooze feature. So, how many times have you received an email and you don't have time to reply right away, or say you're working on something else and you get distracted and forget to respond back? Well, if you hover over the email in your inbox, just click on this little clock icon that appears. And here you're gonna have the option to pick a time to snooze that email until. Meaning, let's say if you pick later in this week, this email will pop back up into your inbox later in the week at that time. And yes, you can pick your preferred time and date too. But you can also access the snooze feature from within an email itself. So let's go ahead and say you've opened up the email. Well, now your snooze option is found at the top of that email message. Now, here's what happens when you pick a date and time to snooze an email. Let's click on later today as an example. And now look, the email is completely gone from the inbox, but do not panic. Like I said, the email will pop back up into your inbox on that date and time chosen. But if you made a mistake and you're like, OMG, where did that email go? Or gee, I stopped scrolling Instagram long enough to actually have time to respond to an email. Well, no worries, you can get that email back, and here's how. Just take a little gander right here at the left-hand side of your inbox, and you may notice the snoozed option. Simply click that option, and voila, here we go. We've got all our snoozed emails right here. Plus, you're even gonna be able to see on the right-hand side of that email list the times and dates that those emails are scheduled to come back into our inbox. And you can also just reply to any of these by clicking on the email. Or if you wanted to, you could even unsnooze the email right from here too by clicking unsnooze. Gmail Snooze has saved me so much time because I used to write down in my to-do list emails that I had to respond to. And sometimes as those emails would come in, I would then update my to-do list, pen to paper, to remind myself to respond to these emails. But with Gmail Snooze, I no longer have to do any of that. Now, moving on to Gmail tip number two. Ooh, this is a good one, and I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Use Gmail templates. I'm a big fan of templates, and this is a massive Gmail time saver. If you haven't used templates before, click the settings gear icon and head to all your settings. Now from here, head to the advanced section and make sure you enable templates. Then click on save changes. Now, every time you write an email, you can save it as a template or insert a previously saved template. So let's say you compose an email that you send all the time, like a job application. You can save it as a template by selecting the three-dot menu icon by the trash can, hover over templates, and then choose save as template. Now, when you go to write that same email the next time, you can simply head back to your templates in the compose window, and this time, select the email template you want to insert. Of course, you can personalize this template from the compose window here too, but the rest of the work is already done for you. And remember, if you're finding these tips valuable, go ahead and give this video a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel for even more content like this. And speaking of the content, let's get back to it. Gmail productivity tip number three is to change your default inbox view. Now, this is gonna be customized to really whatever works for you and what your preferences are. So, click on that gear icon again, and this time, let's pay attention to this right-hand side quick settings panel, specifically the inbox type section. Under the default option, which is what I have here, you actually have the option to customize this if you want as well. So you can select the tabs you want to display, but back in the quick settings, maybe you function best when you have emails marked important pinned to the top of your inbox, or maybe you want unread messages at the top of your inbox. You can adjust all of these views right from here too. You can even put starred first at the top, but one I think that could be useful to help save time in Gmail is the multiple inboxes setting. So if you select the customize option here, you can then select up to 5 custom sections that you want to be displayed alongside your inbox. Now these sections are using something called search operators, which is something I talk about in a video called 5 Gmail Tips for Productivity, which I have linked to in the description below if you want more info on what search operators are. But what you can do is specify the specific recipients or words in a subject line. And if you're wondering how the heck to use these different search operators, you can actually just click on Learn More right here in this pop-up, and then click on Search Criteria. And here's a list of all the different kinds of search operators that you can use. And moving on to one of maybe my favorite Gmail tips of all time. Create task-specific email addresses just by using the plus symbol in your already existing email address. Sounds confusing, but it's not. This is going to blow your mind. So here's how it works and why you're going to want to do this. If you don't want to create multiple accounts or aliases for, say, email newsletter signups or when creating a new account on a brand website, you can simply add a plus symbol to the end of your email address right before the @ symbol. So let me break this down for you. This is a test Gmail account I set up to show you this as an example. This email happens to be TasiaCustodeTest@gmail.com. But say I've got to create an account on a website in order to access, I don't know, a white paper that I want to download or something like that. What I could do is add on to this email address so that I could then filter out these emails in the future and see who is using this specific email that I create. So let's pop over to another account of mine for a second, and let's pretend I've signed up for a digital white paper and I give this email address to the marketing department. But instead of using TasiaCustodeTest@gmail.com, let's say the address I've given them to access that white paper is actually TasiaCustodeTest+digitalmarketing. Okay, and then I'll add the rest of my email address, which is @gmail.com. So again, pretend that you've signed up for a newsletter or whatever it is, and you can add whatever works for your organization to the end of your existing email address before that @ symbol. So magically, I'm just gonna finish writing this fake email that someone is sending me and I'm gonna hit send. Now, let's head back over to my test email account that, remember, is only my name, TasiaCustodeTest@gmail.com. And would you look at that? Here is an email in my inbox from the fake marketer. If we open it up, boom, we can see that the email address they sent to was actually the digital marketing one that I just signed up for that fake white paper. But it's come straight to the email account that I want. I didn't have to create a new email account. Now remember, you can put whatever you want in here, whatever works for you. So now you could filter out any emails sent to this address with plus digital marketing, or say you added plus newsletter, or whatever it is that you've created. Which brings me to our last Gmail productivity tip. Create filters. Specifically, create filters that enable emails to skip the inbox entirely. Now, this is going to help you get your Gmail inbox organized and allow you to spend less time sorting out emails that have hit your inbox. Instead, filter them before they even come to your inbox. Here's how. There are a couple of ways to do this, but using our example from the previous tip, Let's say I want all the emails that have that Tasia Custode test plus digital marketing at gmail.com to skip my inbox and go to maybe a label I've created instead. Well, from the search bar at the top, let's click on show search options to the right. Now, since I'm creating a filter where I want to filter out emails to that specific email I created, I'm gonna put that in the to field because that's who they're sending to. And because I happen to want to filter all those emails out, I'm going to click on create filter. So now here's where things get interesting. We can pick from a myriad of things we'd like to happen when a message matches the criteria we just set. So for this, I could choose to have it skip the inbox completely, which would archive it immediately. Which, by the way, is a good option if you get inundated with junk email to, say, that task-specific email you've created. But what I recommend to do is to leave that skip the inbox toggled on, but also toggle on the option to apply the label. Now, here you can choose from labels you may have already created, or you can create one right from here too if you haven't created one yet. And then, if you have other emails that match the criteria, you can toggle on the apply filter option here at the bottom so that it would filter out all other existing emails like this one. Then what you're gonna do is just click on create filter. And now you will see that the email message that was sent to the task-specific address I made up is now gone from my inbox. And not only that, but we've got the digital marketing label I created now right here on the left-hand panel. And if I click on that label, there's the email we just filtered. Bingo bango, it's that easy. And now that you can spend less time in Gmail, perhaps you can spend more time, I don't know, watching some of my other YouTube videos. I have a ton of other YouTube videos that go over all kinds of things you could ever want to talk about with Gmail. Anything you can think of, I've probably covered it. So be sure to check out all those links in the description below. So what do you think of these Gmail productivity tips? What are your favorites? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for even more Google goodness. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Oops. Excuse me.